Speak for late.
Now I wanna, so long as Silusira get 25, I just no worry. Give her 5 stars.
Music wise, Nikki Nani believe me, I know for you'll make it one day.
Our two brothers and me, it's Helen Chara from childhood. Can not another line of one. So yeah, check it out too.
Pheli Makaveli is a name I came up with. Pheli Spana Project. It was highly suggested by Zuchi Kokdog. Cause we were like experimenting a sound in between like classical hip hop, somehow infusing it with trap music. But as much as the lyrical content, it was more like mature.
Nagi hudistem fana 25 uhola mo pelaka. The boy ki miti from his childhood. Kem fana ebelungori ota anele ale ambitious, blind. Dilo tsa strata nkeng na le kholele tsona wa mfosta nkeng na ibile ke motho e belong na te thatela dilo tsa bona ni a thought hore maybe na yo luka ka mo tabeng tsa bo di sports o nkeng. So throughout ko bophelong a thoma ho rata di dene ya music and ke mo le rena sele artsentsa ra thoma mo followa nkeng.
I call him Timinki because of I couldn't pronounce Lehlohonolo. So that's how the name came up. Lehlohonolo, he's a shy person, very, very shy. But then gore mo music king o tle yang ne ke maketse gore o tlo khona byang a le shy so. And because of Nerkwetse mashata go re kholetse in a tavern, so mashata ha e ana ira go ka moreng ners na problem le ona because of mashata ra tloetse ka mtaverneng.
So now I started having that whole demeanor of like that whole park feel whenever I'd approach a record because I listen to a lot of West Coast hip hop. As much as I listen to like East and West, I listen to a lot of West Coast hip hop and I'm highly influenced by like Dre, Park, Snoop, NWA, Mac Dre, the guys from the Bay like E40, Too Short, like I used to listen to a lot of that kind of hip hop. So the whole park thing was really a thing of like, I'm from Sosville, Black Rock, which is also situated in the west of Pretoria. So the whole west side thing, like I grew up with it. We always refer to like this place as the west.
This is Karabo Jomani, Ounau, Blaro. And yeah, everything is good. I'm from Attridgeville. I'm 25 DJ, partner from the beginning. And yeah, we're here now, Pheli Makaveli. Nertena's Gelas is one from primary till high school. Negi Miti, Nerenamela Bisiwa Wotle, but after I think high school, I started hustling and then like we had different paths. I was more like what I'm doing now, like chasing the dream. Along the way we got back together and started this music thing till now.
So it's a whole Wild West thing. So the whole park thing, it just came as a demeanor because I feel like every artist has their own alter ego. So once I came up with the title of the project, now it made more sense why Pheli Makaveli would be more fitting as a title for my debut project because I'm fully for Pheli and I've always represented that in terms of like my music and me as an individual. So it's been like, it also has a ring to it, like as far as rhyme scheme, like Pheli Veli. So that's how I came up with the name, but it was suggested by Zuchi Kogdo. He's the dealer.
I think we both kind of came up with it only because I felt like his attitude was one that could represent a whole, you know, demographic or a whole, you know, a certain lifestyle or a certain class. So we needed to personify that and like measurable to, I think, one of the best hip hop personas and make it his own. Because I think that's what he means to the place that he's from. So Pheli is Atrichville and Makaveli is like the whole Tupac thing. So putting them together like that, I think sells the whole idea of the album.
Kiti Mubarak Pila Pila is from primary school around 2004-2005. He was not a rapper at that moment. Nanu dlala cricket, normal boy. But eventually hana kwenze ya, muthwa degree ya, I find that talent ya hai, ashiwe mfanomonyani wa rapper.
Our deep breath and me, it's talent chaka from childhood. Kenala naka line wane. So yeah, chwe kitsi la chwe. Ero akaka, time pera wa yi, time pera.
Ita ita wa fetu uzet. Ya nagena David Jeje Maila. Ke bloma muso zili, mo Black Rocko. Ke stylisti. Today go to blala kantu anaka. Today the music ala 25K, mara nage thagi music ele le Lehlohonolo. He's humble.
Just like many artists, Jenny Nails is simple. Nona le batho ba hana mo supporta. Nona le batho ba mo fiela, nye ba ra irisele. Mara hope yona e tlhaile teng gore le o great ne e bontsho ra mfano nya ka something from music industry wa ntshwara.
Sweetie boy. Ke motho e belong hore violence taba tsa bo di drugs. Any wrong doings, I see line ya. Baba, ke mfano mo mo e belong hore o shapo. O rata dilo tse pila. He's a hard worker. Baba.
That's how. The most non obvious way I draw inspiration would be like how I grew up around hustlers. Like all my life, like my uncle was a big time hustler and I kind of got the hustle game from him because he was like one of the people that I looked up to growing up. So in terms of like inspiration as a person and like when it comes to like my talent, it always comes from the people that I keep around me in terms of like when it comes to the music, I draw inspiration from like the streets. Like if I have like maybe per se writer's block and I'm stuck on a lyric or I just hear the beat and I don't have the lyrical content for it, I just spend a few minutes, hours in the streets and then when I go back in the studio and I hear a beat, it's like makes sense.
I told my woe, hold my way, I was broke, yeah. I stole my song, I stole my drip, stole my flow, yeah. I told my woe, I have to do this on my own, yeah. I made hits, my shit back, this shit sounds old. It's too yeah. Many niggas that told, too many niggas that fold. I'm selling walk on the phone, I'm never breaking the code. It's too many niggas that told, too many niggas that fold. I'm selling walk on the phone, I'm never breaking the code. Ke ba ba kae ba tlapheli le ashma, thaba ma ashma. Mpeke bo feeling ke asthma, betha to pull at lara.
Laro is a brand. Yeah, is a brand. Well, it's based on where we come from, which is Black Rock. Took the black and the rock, mixed it up together to find Black Rock. It's about like our culture from like where we come from, like whatever inspires it is what we've encountered or like what we've seen as we were growing up. Yeah, so Le Super, Blaro, Rolex Gang. It's all a part of one thing, just like extensions of our, of us, or where we come from.
You talking about me on socials when I pull up on you, starter. I'm on the phone with my brother, I told him to check on my mother.
Pheli Makaveli has been in the making for like, is it 2 years or 1 year? 1 year something, 1 year mahasha. We've traveled a lot to make that thing happen. Every studio session was a journey. Every beat, everything, like, it was like we were making a movie. And at the time that we started it, it wasn't like we were sure that we were making a movie or something, but we knew that what we were making was gonna like change the face of South African hip hop.
Oh, Pheli. Eish. I'm gonna talk about the Grampy, Lahore 25 figure man. Nete Otan Samara, Nete Flop of Talamara features in Chimaragamara, Pheli Makaveli, Abatalasets and State Street, Rura Langa Motaxi, Lahore 25 figure man, Triple Fagamara Pheli, Dinjaza Pheli, Urju, Tava, Tava Cool, Yori, 25 figure man, Otaka, Rura Langa Tama.
Now, as soon as you got peanuts, I come at home. That is why peanuts are from come round. Did it see what to win? Baba, Nagy warning, as soon as you got music, the boy, you can never know the boy is going places. You surely now have a more at Okonoka, the Garabi, look over to a very demon. He's been following me since. As at now, LSS. Pina mwele mwea haya kale na pilaro LSS. Asata na ludi ya msegwanta. So naga mwone kale. Asata wahuru maybe kikide, maybe lifteke kirele motili. Baba, naga mwone kale praya wahuru is going places.
Okay, 25k ni kipila kimisa di giginza hai. Ki before ava 25k ma. Erso yizuru utlota vele atu magali bizola 25k. And then my favorite song, album. Ghetto Angels, because you mentioned my dad and my other uncle Moyon. And you mentioned in a way that never would treat a thing and never rat.
Obviously, I had to take you to a place where I've made a lot of memories in terms of like my musical journey, because most of my talent, like me realizing what I actually did was made in the premises right behind me. So this is the school that I went to as far as high school. So as far as the music, I think
especially the hip hop industry or the trap, African trap, and so on. So, what does the grab be the horror in game? And then I hope you can tell the Loring Corey nationwide or international local Mara Atu Flopo Otola Kala and then again and to call it with some worry. How sunny it felt like. I have little to say, but Mereko konoto bolela mara naga itse sa
o hambolo bla ene re tsene ke bolela ka ba hambolo ba hae ke first time ke mumita ke before everybody le nna e tlo ba 25 25k ne tlhela le ntwana re Grootman o reng re shapo are ai me Grootman nna ke nna le Lehlohonolo khopela re ngire mo riri ke a itse ba ro these ka miriri eng eng but na Grootman e na a ke na siro a gira le siro ka nna mara ka khopela fela ka ngira mo riri mara khotsena ka mathomo ka re mara mfano ke mang o tsaka e play ka no tla no botsa re yena o nyo gira mo riri jo tsa di go tlase a di a hemella eng ka molebella mara something some buzo xt wa itse bjang first thing the way mfano wa producing ga teng le bo hambolo ba hae name mo try ka rne mfana ke wa itse bjang for the fact ya hore to the way mfano wa producing ga teng ene le plaka mfano na le plaka mara plaka ya se plaka o tella ke plaka ya o tlhompha
yeah so basically this is where like a part of my musical journey sort of started taking off as far as for the fame and stuff like that. So this is my high school that I went to, which is William Secondary School. So I think in like grade 9 we used to have like projects in arts and culture where we would do some stuff that would involve the music and then get more Nerre, Palamachita and whatnot. And then a year later from that, I started recording. Like, Klaus hooked me up with this other homie of his, whom he knew, Nele producer, and he did a song for me. And then now I started wanting to record more. So me recording more slowly led to like the mixtape. And then I dropped the mixtape when I was in high school. And then one song in the mixtape started catching up, and like everybody in my school knew the song.
Pheli Makaveli, ke specter new stuff. Because like industry ke feel nga re stakile on tswa re stakile blind industry arena and vano mfana rena o tlhatla ka new innovative ideas ya trao tsena wa tsena and vano eventually utsene. So I just hope our album e tla re bontsha the full potential ya 25.
Favorite song, one being Conciliate, two, you album, one being I two, Ever Kill and Al Killer X, and then the third one, Killer a-reece, yeah, it all hurt, it all touch.
So, me and my homie Killer X, he's on my album Pheli Makaveli as one of the features as well. So, we started selling mixtapes muske laga for 20 rand, so we had like 50 CDs would sell out in a month, dog. And every time they sell out, people would be like, yo, I want the CD. So those songs started now creating buzz around like Pitori, like because he's from Sosha, so Sosha mom see some schools in town. So from me selling mixtapes from then, I sort of had a name for myself at that time, but I wasn't yet 25K, so I used to call myself Nazy at the time.
I realized that 25K was a pop music. The day I was 25K, I was a Muslim. I was a Muslim. Muri music in Sahai or eh, Mansua. Mara like my Muslim Renali, this special bond your Pelarnal Bobu, every Friday, Rubu, Mansua. So like by 25K, Ascolabo Nahalagamara group will have Rita. Nebun Tor, we create a high improve the Camu music. Cause like music in it was a hobby, Pilapi, Lansua. But eventually, I'm going to go to the house. So, like, I'm going to go to the house. I'm going to go to the 25K. So, eventually, I'm going to go to the industry.
So, yeah, basically, that same year that I was selling mixtapes, a year later from that, I failed the school year, so I had to like take a break from music and start focusing more on my studies because my mom couldn't understand that proper. So from me taking that break, I also started having thoughts of like maybe I'm gonna pursue another career path and stuff like that. So after high school, I sort of had that thing where I felt like I outgrew music, so I let go of the music a bit. And then as I was hustling in the streets, like me and Klaus used to do a lot of hustling. Like as we were hustling in the streets and we were listening to all this trap music, Klaus was like, yo, all the stuff we be doing in the streets is what people be talking about in all these songs and you living this thing. Why don't you just go back to the music and start telling that story? I was like, echo, but I'll try maybe one song and then we'll see where it goes. And then that's when I dropped a song called The Ziploc King, because I used to have a lot of zips on me at that time. And then that song was one of those songs that contributed to me calling myself 25K, because the first song I dropped with the title 25K, I dropped it with my homie Killer X. It was a song called Frostan on the Chief Keef, I Don't Like Beat. So that's when I did the name switch and I called myself 25K, because I was making a lot of beats at the time. A lot of beats. I wasn't rapping as much as I was before. I was more on making beats, but I couldn't find artists to put on my beats. So that's how I started this whole thing of like rapping on my own beats and creating my own sound.
I grew up with my nigga. How many times we hear licks in the slums with the ops? I won't kill you, I lie, you my nigga. All of the times we hear nothing, I thought you would fall, but instead it's all love with your nigga. I told my mama I'm running my race, she told me to focus, I lie, you little nigga. How many times I got bullets and pigeons to show you that I'm finna die for my niggas, I'll die for my niggas. Los Avalelegas, I got some funnel, I'll deck you, my nigga. I'm on the block with the shooters and robbers, I told you, Rona Norcadala, my nigga. It's blood on my niggas, 24 zips on the project, my nigga. I'm having nightmares of enemies pulling up on me, don't.
I listen to a lot of overseas based artists. In terms of like the style of music that I listen to is mostly trap, so I listen to like a lot of genres, like music in general to me, but like what I mostly listen to is like trap music. So I listen to like those underground bass trap artists like Big Scar, Pusha T, and them before they came up. I was listening to Migos before they came up, Lil Baby before he came up, Ghana, Drip or Drown 1, 2 before he came up. So me listening to like that type of sound influenced me hearing those type of beats. And when a producer would send me like a beat like that, or maybe let's say I'm in a session with Zuchi Code Dope and he plays a beat similar to like most of the stuff that I listen to, I like to like stay true to myself, because I'm a kid from like Kasi, basically like Nagam Fana Pheli. So wherever I'm at, or if it's a song, if people see me somewhere, I'd like to leave that mark so that people know that mfano lagu mfano kopeli. So I always do that with my music. So if I hear a beat that sounds too overseas, I always bring it back home by sounding vernac but also infusing it with English at the same time, so both people can like relate to like what I'm saying.
Whether they're not humble, but this boy, something. Sorry, sometimes when you are humble, you know, go and knock at the door, but don't kokota ka kokota pila, and then that's why he is where he is today, because he's so humble. Mo hotle mayang wa kokota, and then why put or sele ke snyaka go to skrea mari senka first. So ntwe ke ntwe ke itseng ka mfana
o bana ho bereka ha ho bereka lo show ka story sao
and story sa se le nnete se le straightforward se sna di khoma ho sna motho o thusitseng ka eng there's no way industry to recognize industry has to recognize 25k because ke mfana ka si po straightforward azanga bolela maka in any way.
I don't really like to like refer to like people that I know from like my past or like people that I grew up with or the streets using a term that's like gangsters, cause like I'd say it in the music lyrical content wise, but to me it's really like they really like my brothers, like some of these people that I mentioned in these songs. So it's like one person I grew up with made a mistake in his life and that mistake cost him his freedom and now he's locked down. So from time to time, they try to reach out to me, I try to reach out to them, we having a conversation. To me, it's really like genuinely a people's conversation where I'm like, yo, like genuinely checking up on the person. So in terms of like Pretoria West and like where I'm like from, which is Sourceville, Black Rock, this place has been known for like the unemployment, the petty crimes, the big crimes, and sometimes when you don't come from my world, you wouldn't understand how people end up in those situations. So it's like Motomwane would resort to that because to Yana that's like Anna, any other choice, and like legit no other choice because maybe they did a mistake in the past that they can't erase now, which put them in a situation whereby Spanish sapala scale as a body. So it's like how they try to put food on the table, and like me, I'd like to refer to those people as like hustlers because that's where I get the motivation from. Like seeing the Golf 6 GTI, seeing the Golf 7 GTI, seeing the M3, the M4, the old school 325, like it's motivation for a kid like me who comes from the lower when you see a whip that fly.
The reason I have a soft spot for Lehlohonolo, it's because of Kokwa Kaunchetsi yena. Her last words was Kitlhokomele Lehlohonolo, so that's what I'm doing now, and I'm still gonna do it. Whether it becomes rich or not, I'm still gonna do it.
Like family is everything for me. Like my mom, she's like, I put her through the worst with me making mistakes in the past, trying to figure out what I'm trying to do with this life thing before I found out that, yo, I'm 25K. Like, so that's the person that always closest to my heart. So I'd say one, my mom. Two, I'd say friends, like the people you keep close. It doesn't necessarily have to be like the people that you grew up with, but it's also good to like check up on those kind of people because they know you better, because they know you before you become like a public figure or a certain known individual. So like the people that you keep around you at all times.
I want the smoke if you talk about trap. 20 kilo nangai kabaka slab. And I'm on the hini, I don't fuck a day. San salamu ras, la cholo go check. A couple on tap, a trouble as cat. I hit her once and she calling me back. All of my boss put knives in my bag. Got a shooter on hole in my phone in this trap. Yeah, and I boca them with tats. Take a little bit of my threat. They tell me to support the fam.
I'm just like a regular kid, man, who came out from like a township that has less privilege. So I was like always a regular kid. All the chains, the grills, and the fame, whatever comes with it, I was always that kid. Like one bala, I was there. Talamogogo, I was there. Like Ras Pai Pai, I was there. So my childhood was like kind of adventurous, and even in school, like as much as I believe
was an average show. Spending dollars on designer dripping head to toe, you had to know.
I don't know how to put it, but I don't think I'm like an introvert, but I think I'm in between an extrovert and an introvert. Like, I'm like a balance of the two. So in terms of like activities, I always include myself and like get involved in terms of like playing with other kids. And when it comes to like music as well, like I'm keen to like working with a lot of people, as long as me and you like we share the same vision and goals. So as a kid looking at me right now, I feel like I'd be motivated regardless of whether I come from a township or not. It's just that thing of defying the odds and chasing your dream regardless by any means until like you reach your goal and like where you wanna be or where you wanna take it in terms of like your dream. So it's like for a kid looking at me myself personally, I believe like I'm like a good figure in terms of like me as a person, because like the music and like the whole hip-hop aesthetic thing can depict an image where it kind of looks like I'm this badass person, but like my nieces, my nephews, like they look up to me because they know I'll be on some genuine tips. So I think I'm like motivation.
Bluffing, turning nothing to something. On the block I would hustle. Dope game is a puzzle. I was made for the struggle. Had to wait for this awesome. CEO like I'm Russell. No iTunes get cussed. Deacon does have fair. Like a boss guy fast. Hello boss guy fast. Hello boss guy fast. Hello boss guy. Hello boss guy.
I met him. I met 25K. I think around 2018-19. Oh, I think it was 2018 going on to 19 maybe. And I heard his song at the show and I asked his DJ who he was and I just asked for his social media handles, and I hit him up and I told him I wanted to work with him on an album. Because what I heard at the show is something I had never heard before, and I wanted to build on it and make a whole body of work around the fire sound that he had going. Yeah, and that's how I made him. He came to see me, I think, a day later, maybe a day or two later. When I was stuck in between, like, not making music and, like, trying to make music, like, those were the guys I would listen to, like, SA hip hop wise. I've listened to, like, let's say hip hop before it started becoming a thing, like even from kids back in the day, like from the Motswako listers to like the backpack rappers to like the Cap City rappers, the Hype Mag mixtapes. Like I used to listen to a lot of SA hip hop, and I used to listen to Zoo a lot as well. Felt like he's like a unique character in terms of like that sound and SA, and the content in his lyrics and his production is just something else. And so one time after, before I even dropped the video for Culture Vulture, I actually got a direct message from Zoo on my Twitter, I think, and he was like, yo, are you down to work? I was like, damn, this is crazy. Of course I'm down to work. He was like, yo, pull up to my spot and then we'll session and then we'll take it from there, because I'm trying to know who this guy really is. So when I pulled up on Zoo, I was with Gloss and Boomy. Yeah, first time I pulled up on Zoo, I was with Gloss and Boomy, and it was legit vibes. And I think I had just shot the Culture Vulture video. I played it for him, and to him it was overwhelming because he was like, yo, I was right. Like, this guy, he's on some whole next level type of ish. So I left that session with one song recorded, and he sent me a few beats, like genuinely it was like a show, feel free. If you have a setup, go and not that, you can record that. It's a fella too. Monate. Nah, how need a fella get thing? If you need beats, sawara, here's my number, hit me up. So, funny enough, when I got back home, the next day, from the batch of beats he had sent me, it's Chora Bumi. I'm like, Echo Bumi, pull up on me, Echo. Then Echo, it's crazy. It's like Echo, didn't I play him one beat? It's a song. I play him another beat, it's a song. It's like, Echo, I've never heard you sound like this before. And so ever since then, I've been pulling up on Zoo. Like, even after I dropped the video for Culture Vulture, we've been having these sessions, and we didn't really think it would amount to a project.
I mean, we hope it's for everyone, but if it's not, then I think it's gonna do its job with the actual target market. But there is no specific target market where, like, trying to have it for those people only.
All this time that I've actually been in studio with Zoo, like getting to know Zoo, like it's not that artist relationship, regular like type of relationship, like he's like bro, like for real, on the phone him, he's like basically put like we can stay on the phone, talk everything besides the music, but obviously you know the music is the business. That always has to be first priority, but like whenever I need to holler about something, like I can always pick up the phone, hit up Zoo. It just vibes. So the music is just a plus, and it's a blessing that we can be bros like that, and then the music just flows out of us effortlessly. It's crazy. But I feel like people don't recognize the talent that's in Zoo as much as they should. They do, but I don't think as much as they should, because I think like Zoo is like genius level, like talent, like for real. He's like brought the best out of most people, especially me, because like me, I've always knew like when it comes to like Kasi rap or Kasi trap, like I have the fire. Like it don't matter who you are, like for real, my dog. And that's how I approach all my songs. But as much as if it's a Zuchi beat, I hear myself sounding like something I've never heard before, but it's always been there.
Like as far as what people can expect, I think they can't really expect much, because a lot of it is the unexpected from how he's rapping and how he's carrying out a whole theme and a whole, you know, idea. I don't think he's ever been the way he is on any other records except for this album. I've never heard him rap the way he rapped on this album anywhere else. So I don't think it's a question of what can they expect, or because I think it's the unexpected entirely.
So the content in my project is mostly inspired by like where I come from, like real stuff, no cap. Like where I come from, it's a lot of stuff that can happen like on a regular day. It's like that's a lot. I've seen the worst, like, and I feel like some of the things I've seen, they too graphic for me to tell, but like I've been through it. Not in terms of like me being a violent person, but like I've seen that side of life where I've had like a near death experience. Like I've been in situations where we got shot at. I've been in situations where I almost lost my life. I've been in situations where people close to me almost lost their lives. Situations where people I know lost their lives, and like where I come from, that's a regular thing. But to me, it's deep, because the way we downplay it, it's like a regular thing, and it's really not.
I don't really have a favorite song. I like the body of work, I like everything about the album, but I wouldn't say this song is my favorite, because every single song, there's a song we liked separately, like on its own first.
Ah, man. Oh, man, I'm going to do something. Hey, you like this. Is it that you come or
you could have, you already made the move.
Right? Yes.
Could have checked them.
Hey, Jonah, my dog. Hey, suicide.
We already 40%, 50% done with the next project. Right? We're doing it until, you know, we can't do it. We're halfway done the next project.
One thing I'd say is like the talent in Pheli is actually crazy. Like, in terms of like any field, like artists, like if I grew deep, grew up in Pheli, like Jay, Benzel, Sing Master, Machaba, Pucho Mojo, like there's a lot of people that actually came from that place. So the talent in Pheli is one thing people might not realize, but it's actually overflowing.
Pyrex on my wrist, dope boy, I'm Mitch, but I can't die for a break. I got the trap jumping, I'm having lunch in Santen. Pelirik ke bumten, money but lives on a mountain. I got the trap jumping, I'm turning nothing to something. Wanna get one of my options, I cannot chest assumptions. I got the trap jumping, I'm having lunch in Santen. Pelirik ke bumten, money but lives on a mountain. I got the trap jumping, I'm turning nothing to something. Wanna get one of my options, I cannot chest assumptions. I keep my strength on the trap, limbo like Samala Jack. Check I got bound to West, okay, but I got Tala West. One on Hata Mosela, I don't like a key lampela. Meta getting top pela, Hosa Twarzaga wa Kenya. The Feto Tana Ligila, Hyde Park Raspina. I said Red Bad Elimina, I'll slime Guy Mina. Gold Rush or a Habo Sheesh, I said Boga no to get Lebanon. Feel a mega, a marathon, if you're not a ghost to get Ladaton. One out there, I got the Tori Tori. Eight down, I got territory. Give up a car, I'll be Tori Troy. Single a thing or a sepilo. I got Tora 2 Bomboni. When I live in Letta Tabata, I got in Yaga selfie, the Tagata. I'm a cook boy when I'm on top, but I don't sniff for me cash talk. 30k, no cap talk, and I catch a saga, I get to it all. Me and Close all breaks, hope the crew done this. It's a real, it's a this. Digging down, take a chase. I got the trap jumping, I'm having lunch in Santen. Pelirik, keep bumping. Money believes.